So they've done it again. Basically, on the 5th of June, it was my birthday. And for my birthday, Mango Girl, Keiji, and Kullanami came together and they made Chapter 1 of Get Hansened. If you don't know, there was a prologue about that leading up to Chapter 1. And finally, now that Chapter 1 is here and they're going to release it on a monthly deadline, to which I'm so pumped and so impressed about because the amount of work and effort they've done. Apparently, they've written out the whole story. They've got a light novel version out as well that they're working towards. And just, I cannot just be any more fucking grateful. So please, the most I can do is tell you guys to go check them out, go show them some love, some support, and hopefully if this all kicks off and you guys love it, I would love to put my own money into funding this and making it into a comic for anyone to get if they wanted to, and just for me because I really want it in a physical form. That'd be cool. Anyway, let's talk about this chapter, because this chapter just went from 0 to 10 very fucking quickly. I feel like if I had to critique this, which I'm not really going to because I'm very biased, but if I had to critique this, I would say that there was, from the start of the chapter, it was very cool, it was relaxed, we kind of came back from what the prologue was, and then suddenly, without a doubt, it just went from decapitating heads straight off the bat, and I'm just like, well, talk about setting up the fucking mood into, oh, okay, that just happened. Which I guess for some of you edgy kids, that may work. If this was in an anime form, they'd be like, oh my god, this is so dark and edgy, which this is probably what they were going for. But anyway, I do want to say, because I'm more familiar with these guys' character designs, I was very much impressed by the house sculptures and the backgrounds in general. I feel like they did an amazing job. Mango, for the most part, really tried to put in every aesthetic she could within this, and it fucking just succeeded. But in all honesty, she got the detail down to a T. I don't know where the park came from, because I don't really live next to a park, but anyway, doesn't really matter. Actually, no, let me criticize it again. I don't go outside, so the fact that you made me go outside my house, I'm a weeb. I'm an anime fan. Anime fans don't go outside. Like, come on. That's just an automatic plot hole right fucking there. But no, in all seriousness, we're going through a park, we see Keiji, he's there with his full bring called the Crown of Pen, and what it seems like it's doing right now is that he can decapitate people's heads with this ability, and it also looks like he's drawing something on the bodies or on the floor, I'm not quite sure. And what really struck me the most is that he was wearing gloves. Now, is there a reason why he's wearing gloves? Does he want to not have, like, DNA kind of traced back to him? Like, what does he do with these bodies? And again, if this is kind of like a full bringish type power, is that sure? Surely it has an ability other than what his original reason, which is as a mangaka, he uses these heads as reference and he has like a whole studio full of heads. Like, this is some creepy shit. This is like some Hunter Hunter type shit where, you know, fucking Kurapika's sitting there with all those scarlet eyes just kind of scattered all around him. And I was also told that some of the heads were references to other people. So to be honest, I couldn't really guess who they were. I mean, I have like somewhat of an idea, but I don't want to seem stupid. So I'll leave that for another time. But whatever it is kind of surreal because we go into this, I see Keiji doing this kind of jazz, cutting people's heads open and that, and I start to feel somewhat some pain or some queasiness, and I'm not being touched by the pen and he's nowhere near me. So what's going on there? Is this to do with his ability? Obviously, he wants to get my head too, he wants to sever it. But the strange fact that he knows me for doing Bleach reviews, and obviously, we both have an interaction with each other and we both know each other. So what's going on here? What is his ability? And I feel like what the chapter did the best within this was kind of demonstrate that there is a lot of foreshadowing and a lot of mystery towards what this ability can do. Because I have to question, is this now going to be the ability that is going to give me powers on later on? Because of course, if this is going to be a battle shonen, I assume that, you know, there is going to be powers implemented at some point within the story. And the question is how am I going to get those powers? Is it going to be to his full bring or his ability? Who's going to kickstart this all off? Because it seems like at the moment I'm very unaware of the surroundings that are going on right now. I'm very unaware, I'm very dense to who these characters are. Can that due to be like I haven't seen them in ages or I haven't spoke to them in a long time? Like, what's the backstory here? And I guess the more we go on to the story, the more we learn out. But for so far, just the fact of introducing characters, showing their kind of overall aesthetic and their design when being presented in the chapters, having like almost a full page spread just to show them is pretty good. The detail is really nice. When it comes to facial expressions, I do feel like this chapter really focused on the shock value and different like realistic terms of like what the fuck is going on. Like, you can actually see that within the characters. And I feel like even when it comes to stuff like eye twitching, really hit the scale on the mark. But overall, I have actually got a question as well. What's going on with Keiji? For a guy that just wants to do manga, And obviously, he's using his heads for reference. Why does he feel the need to kill people? Does the internet not exist? I don't know, maybe I'm putting too much logic into this, and of course, we'll probably learn a lot more later on down the road. Maybe this pen doesn't even kill the actual person in the first place, it just keeps them as a severed head, and, you know, their body and head are separate, and they can still breathe or whatever, just like, like a headless horseman, you know, they can carry their heads without, like, any kind of attachment. Anyway, getting off topic. But I don't know, it seemed like one of those chapters that was mainly a big, massive cock tease for a lot to come, a lot to be explained, and that's what I like about the chapter, is that there is a lot to go on. Even though we've only had two chapters, there's a lot to discuss. What are these powers? How am I going to get powers? Where's this story leading on to? What are the motives behind these characters so far? And just the overall world and environment, again, like, to me, special place in my heart, because that is what I see every day, so it is weird to kind of put myself in this position. It's like, you know, you put your headphones on, you walk down the street, or you walk to a store or something, and you just imagine these random scenarios that would never happen in the real life, but someone's actually done this in a manga form. It's weird, exciting, but the references I liked. I like the Ichika and the Kazui on the Shonen Jump cover. I like that the heads are actually people, but I don't know who, but I do like the clothing, and I looked at the clothing as well. I just couldn't imagine who they would be. And again, I just like the interactions with the characters, because that's exactly how it would be, because I am dense as fuck, and I'd be like, wait, who? What? And again, I gotta give a hats off to the facial expressions. I feel like they were the main PowerPoint within this chapter. So, I actually cannot wait for chapter 2. Again, I can't express my gratitude enough. Please go check them out. The links will be, of course, in the description down below. I seriously don't deserve this, but again, just to show my appreciation, this is just my thoughts. Obviously, I'm trying to keep the fanboyism down and trying to look at this in a different perspective of, like, where can this go, and question everything that's going on. So, of course, tell you guys what your thoughts are in the comment section down below. What do you guys want to see? If you want to get involved or anything like that, there is a Discord link also in the description. It is my Discord. And if you want to talk to any of the creators there, then you can do. But I am going to leave it off with that. You guys, of course, have this fine day, Hanson. I'm going to catch you motherfuckers later. And as always, people, peace out.